Hello, my dear friends. Today we are going to discuss on parametric and non-parametric tests. It is thought that validity and accuracy of hypothesis testing depends upon the selection of statistical test. And automatically it comes to mind, what is the main study hypothesis? Does it mean that all studies include hypothesis testing? In some cases, there is no hypothesis at all. The investigator just wants to see what is there. For example, if we take a prevalence study, there is no hypothesis to test. Even the size of the study is determined by the investigator with assumption of accuracy that what investigator wants in terms of prevalence. Here we find out prevalent odd ratio and prevalence ratio like that. Still, in many cases, testing of hypothesis is done using various tests of significance. Among them, parametric and non-parametric tests are important. So, test of significance, if you can recall, is a procedure to assess the significance of a statistic or difference between two independent statistics. So it can be said as the difference between a statistic and corresponding population parameter, or the difference between two statistics. So here the question is coming, what is statistics or what is parameter, population parameter? So you can see here that statistical constants of population like mean variances are called as parameters. So the main thing is statistical constants of population as parameters. While those of samples, if we talk, those are called as statistics. So parameters are numbers that summarize data for an entire population, and statistics are numbers that summarize data from a sample. That is some subset of entire population. Sample means some subset of entire population. You can see in this picture, whole is taken as population mean. In that, lot of samples are given, like these different colors, circles you can see. Here you will find the mean is shown through M, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, while these variances are shown through S1, S2, S3, S4, S5. So exactly these are for the samples, while population mean is mu. So population mean is parameter, while for these samples, those means are called as statistics. Now we will see assumptions of statistical tests. In statistical analysis, all parametric tests assume some certain characteristics about the data. These are also known as assumptions. So assumptions are some characteristics assumed for that parametric test. So statistical tests are performed based on those assumptions only. Violation of any assumption may mislead the statistical analysis, or sometimes may be completely erroneous. These assumptions, if we talk, they are like normality. Normality of data means symmetrical graph, or Bell-shaped graph, or according to central limit theorem, if sample size is more than 30, then distribution of data can be ignored, and parametric test can be taken for analysis. Central limit theorem, if you recall, that exhibits a phenomenon where the average of sample means and standard deviations equal the population mean and standard deviation, which is extremely useful in accurately predicting the characteristics of populations. So after normality, another point is homogeneity of variances. For that, we used to perform certain tests to check equality of variances in group of data, as F test is used to compare the variances of two samples, while Varlet's test or Levens test we use to compare the variances of multiple samples if we are using. Now here you can see this is not homogeneous, because you can see two of these sample variances, these are coming differently. So these are not homogeneous. And if this is not homogeneous, so what test we should perform? So that's the important assumption. Same way here you can see with this graph, one side it is shown as normal, other side it is shown positively and negatively skewed. So that skewed one is not normal. So based on assumptions, we have to see these things. Accordingly, we have to opt for specific statistical tool. So what we find from this? If data make assumptions about the parameters, it means they are following probability distribution of population from which sample is drawn. As we have already seen that parameters define the population distribution. Whenever population distributions are followed, we should perform parametric statistical test. If data are distribution free, it means they are not following population's distribution, then non-parametric tests should be used. So non-parametric tests are usually performed when sample size is small, means when it's not easy to assess the distribution, whether normality is there or not there, or in another case when data are measured on categorical scale. If data are distribution free, then median is calculated instead of mean. That we will see when we are talking with the specific test. Now we will see some of the differences between parametric and non-parametric tests. Like parametric tests are based on distribution of data, that's nothing but the normality, while non-parametric tests are distribution free. Another difference is parametric tests use mean for analysis, while median is used by non-parametric tests for analysis. Then we find that parametric tests are applicable for variables, while non-parametric tests are applicable for both variables and attributes. So here again the matter comes, what is attribute? So variables, if you can recall, those are the characteristics which vary across the data. While attributes are specific quality, characteristics or features for that specific variable. So here in non-parametric test, both variables and attributes are counted. If you take example also, so like we talk for variable, if that's the gender, so attributes are male and female. Or when we talk about the variable like agreement, then attributes may be strongly disagree, disagree, neutral, agree, strongly agree. These all are the attributes of agreement. So these examples you can understand from this. What is that? Then another difference is there. For parametric test, there must be strong assumptions of data, while non-parametric tests rely on fewer assumptions only. Parametric tests, when we talk, they can handle numerical data, while non-parametric tests use categorical data. You can go in details about the types of data from our another video, data and their types. So that will make you understand in very easy way what are the things are there, because understanding of subject is important. Now another difference is there. Parametric tests are seriously affected by outliers, while non-parametric tests are not seriously affected by outliers. Outliers, if you can understand, those are observations which lies at an abnormal distance from other value in a random sample from a population. Suppose if we talk about sodium range in serum, that's 133 to 146 millimole per liter. But if sample reports with 75 millimole per liter or 210 millimole per liter, so that one or two of this individual sample is reporting that way, it means that's going and that will disturb the mean of complete of this. So that's coming as outlier. So if outlier is affecting, then we are not performing parametric test. But non-parametric test can be taken because it is relying on median only. Then we find that parametric tests have more statistical power than non-parametric tests to reject null hypothesis. It means to accept alternative hypothesis. Here you can see statistical tests for paired or matched observations like pre-treatment and post-treatment. So variable, if that's nominal, we perform McNamara's test. If it is ordinal, we perform Wilcoxon test. If it is quantitative, but discrete and non-normal data are there, then again Wilcoxon test we are performing. If it is quantitative, with normal data and data are continuous, then we are performing paired t-test. Same way, here you can see some parametric tests and their non-parametric equivalents. Like for paired t-test, we are performing Wilcoxon rank sum test. On paired t-test, Mann-Whitney U-test we are performing. For correlations or association between two variables, in parametric one, we are performing using Pearson correlation. While in non-parametric, we are using Spearman rank correlation. And for one-way ANOVA means more than two variables are there. So analysis of variance in parametric we are using. While in non-parametric, we are using Kruskal-Wallis test. Chi-square test is used for a nominal variable. The variables should be discrete and in mutually exclusive categories. The data should consist of frequencies or counts for each category. So these are the basic differences of parametric and non-parametric tests, along with the basic details of different types of parametric and non-parametric tests. So we also found from this that when we have to perform parametric tests or non-parametric tests. So, I think this is enough. The details we will see when we are going with hypothesis testing for a specific parametric or non-parametric test. There we can find out with example how we are performing which test. So, thanks a lot. Thank you very much. If you like this video, please like and share this video, subscribe this channel. We will cover the whole syllabus of BMS and MD for research methodology and biostatistics. Thanks again.